हेलो मेड स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पी वेंकटेश्वर लू पीजीटी फिजिक्स दीनदयाल पब्लिक स्कूल. ओके, सो कमिंग टू टुडे कंटेंट, आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम वर्क एनर्जी पावर. द रिमेनिंग कंटेंट ऑफ वर्क एनर्जी पावर माइंड चिल्ड्रन. ओके, द टॉपिक इज मोशन इन ए वर्टिकल सर्कल मोशन. Motion in a vertical circular motion. Okay, see here, it is clear, my children. Okay. It's clear, motion in a vertical circular motion. Okay. So if that side heading will not appear, listen carefully. Motion in a vertical circular motion. Okay. So what is circular motion, my children? Yes. So a particle moves in a circumference of circle. Okay, that type of motion we can say circular motion. Okay, understand? This is called circular motion. Particle moves along the circumference of circle is known as circular motion. Okay, so coming to vertical circular motion means like this. Okay, circular motion means circular path. Okay, understand? So here vertical circular motion means like this. Okay, so horizontal means like this, vertical means like this. Okay, understand? So here some formulas we need to know, we need to understand, we need to remember. Okay, which is very very important one. Okay, so consider a vertical circular motion means consider a particle and tie a thread and drill like vertical. Okay. Okay, understand? This is center, this is L, length of the thread. Okay, or radius. Okay, here some points we need to know. Okay, see here, after three points we have to take. 1, 2, 3, 4 are A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Okay. So, here, at A, at B, at C, at D, okay, the particle requires some minimum velocity. Okay. That particle needs some minimum velocity. So, how we can find that minimum velocity means, I will explain, but there is no derivation. Okay, there is no derivation, my dear children. Okay, just you remember that formula. Okay, here the minimum velocity of the particle to complete one vertical circle, that v is equal to root of phi g l r, root of phi g r. Okay, root of phi g l r, phi g r. Okay. So if the particle having this amount of velocity, the particle completes one vertical circular motion. Okay. So if the particle having less than the root of phi g l, the particle will not complete the vertical circular motion. Okay. Understand? Next, at B, at C. Okay. The minimum velocity is root of 3 g l. V minimum is equal to root of 3GLR, root of 3GR. Okay, R means radius. G means acceleration due to gravity.
G means acceleration due to gravity merchant. Okay, so after D, okay, the minimum velocity of the particle to complete one circular motion or vertical means after D, velocity of point D, it is root of GL or root of GR, root of GR. Understand, my children, it is visible or not? Okay, clearly visible. Okay, understand. See here, at the point A, the minimum velocity of the particle V is equal to root of 5GL. So, less than this, the particle will not complete one circular, vertical circular motion. Okay, so at B, if the minimum velocity of the particle at B and C is root of 3GL or root of 3GR. So, if the particle having less velocity than that of root of 3GR, the vertical circular motion will not completed. Okay, there is no undergoes a particle one complete vertical circular motion, my children. Understand? So, at point D, root of GL. Okay, if the minimum velocity at D is root of GL, if less than that, the particle will not complete one vertical circular motion. Okay, understand? See here, if the velocity of the particle, is less than 3GL, velocity less than root 5GL. Okay, understand? So the particle having velocity is less than 3GL and less than 5GL. Okay, so the particle will oscillates. Understand? So if the particle having such type of particle having less than 3GL and less than 5GL, the particle oscillates like this. Okay, understand, my children? Okay, so here, so the particle will oscillates. Okay, understand? So if the particle having velocity greater than 5GR and 3GR, the particle will complete vertical circular motion. Okay, this is very, very important content, my children. Okay, so next, my children, various forms of energy. Various forms of energy. Various forms of energy, my children. Okay, see here, what is energy? Energy means the ability to do work, my children. Okay, so here, types of energies is there. Okay, mechanical energy, it is defined as the sum of the potential and kinetic energy. Sum of the potential energy plus kinetic energy is called mechanical energy. Next, light energy. Okay, so light is a form of energy. So due to the source of light is sun. Okay, so next, chemical energy. The energy possessed by the substance. Okay, the energy possessed by the chemical substance is known as chemical energy. Then, electrical energy. electrical energy. Okay, so the energy, okay, the work done or the energy due to the flowing of charge through a conductor. Okay, flowing of charge through a conductor known as electrical energy. Electrical energy. Understand? So here, yeah, these are the types of energies. Okay, so we are used in daily life, my children. Okay, so according to Einstein, mass energy relation, mass energy relation. Okay, see here, Einstein said in 1905, so the amount of mass which is converted into energy, the amount of mass is converted into energy, this gives Einstein energy mass relation. Okay, so E is equal to mc square. E is equal to mc square. E is the energy, m is the mass of the substance, c is the speed of light. Speed of light 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second, my children. Understand, my children? Yes. Okay, the speed of light is 3 into 10 power 8, my children. Okay, here, so the amount of energy which gives E is equal to mc square by Albert Einstein in 1905. Okay, according to Einstein, if we can have 1 kg amount of substance which is converted into energy, so we can get the amount of energy E is equal to 1 into 10 power 8 meter per second. 10 power 8 meter per second. So E is equal to 1 kg into 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Okay, here E is equal to 300 into 10 power 6 of joules. 300 mega joules. Okay, understand? So 300 mega joules. So this amount of energy which released when 1 kg mass is converted into 1 kg mass is converted into energy. Understand, my children? How the mass is converted into energy? Yes. Okay. So next, coming to content is power. What is power, my children? So what is power? Okay, yes, power, it is defined as work done by time. Okay, power is equal to work done by time. Work done by time, the rate of doing work. The rate of doing work, my children. The rate of doing work is called power. Power, it is also defined as energy per time. Energy per time. Okay, so we have average power. Average power is equal to work done by total time. Total time. So then PAVG is equal to work done by time. Understand, my children? Understand. Next, instantaneous time. Instantaneous time means the average power delivered by a person or machine. So in a time interval of zero or small, if the time interval is small or undergoing to
zero.
So means limit delta t tends to zero dw by dt. Okay, dw by dt. This is called instantaneous power. Instantaneous power, it is defined as the power of a machine or the power of a person at the time, at a particular time of instant, or the time continuously undergoing zero. Okay, zero continuously, it will become zero or less time, less interval of time. Okay, so understand, another definition is there. Okay, the product of force and velocity is called power. Okay, it is a scalar quantity. You can write Fv cos theta. Okay, power, it is defined as the product of force and velocity, its velocity, P is equal to Fv cos theta. It is a scalar product. Understand what I said? It is a scalar product. Okay, coming to units of power. SI units. So first, what is the formula? Yes, power is equal to work done by time or energy per time. Okay, so what is the SI unit? SI unit is joule per second. So this joule per second, we can say watt. Okay, so understand, 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. Understand? Okay, see here, some other values of power is there. Means 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watts. Okay, 1 megawatt is equal to 10 power 6 watts. Okay, so 1 HP, 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts. Okay, so are you following my children? Okay, these are the conversions. Okay, understand? So then dimension formula, we know that SI unit is joule per second. Okay, so we have to write a dimension formula, energy per time, m power 1 l power 2 t power minus 2 by t power 1. Rearrange this, m power 1 l power 2 t power minus 3. So this is the dimension formula, my dear children. Okay, what is the dimension formula? M power 1 l power 2 t power minus 3. This is the dimension formula for power. Okay, so power is a scalar quantity. Understand? So Fv cos theta and work done by time, these are the units. Okay, units and formula. Okay, and some main conversions is there in the power. Okay, so we know that 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per 1 second. Okay, see here, 1 horsepower. Okay, so 1 horsepower, it is the unit of measuring power for a, machines. Okay, some machines you can find that is horsepower, how much horsepower of electric motors. So like that machines. Okay, 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts. Okay, so understand, these are the main conversions. And commercial unit of measuring electrical energy is kilowatt hour is equal to 3 into 10 power 6 joule. Okay, 3 into 10 power 6 joules madichindam. Okay, madichindam. So up to this today's session completed, my dear children. Okay, so understand? Yes.